and Super Gallery. It would be really interesting to hear, Prinshila, your take on how it has been watching all of these developments over the past few decades, observing the Nigerian and African arts landscape.
Well, to start with, I remember when I left Vasoba, when I was in Vasoba, I was collecting small pieces. And then I left Vasoba on an art course to do some internationalization, came back and found myself going to 15 Osholaki District in Abuja, where an honorable is, where I lived. And I saw the works of Adarabulu on the floor. In fact, they were using one or two of his works to pack it. That was how bad it was there. People did not appreciate what art was all about. And Kolade Osun, who also mentioned his own experience in this direction, where people did not appreciate what art was all about. I remember that anyone who died 90s, late 90s, and that his work did not sell more than 1 million naira. He died of dying, but Kabita knows better than I do how much his work was for that. I remember going down to Uromi, going to Kano, and so on and so forth, to buy, you know, antique works. And I remember when I was doing my postgraduate, people knew I was collecting works, and one of the sisters of my classmates ran to me and told the brother to tell me that while they were digging the foundation in their home in Ife, they came across some works. At that time, nobody gave it up. I'm talking about 1981. The country was not aware of the value of these works. We were not. Everything was around government material. And I remember the first auction.